Hey Maplers, Coppersan here. We're training Reboot's favorite class to level 200, Kana. This class is super popular in both Reboot and the regular server, mainly because of her skill that increases monster spawn. Kana is a fast grinding mage class with one of the best link skills in the game as well, increasing damage by 10%. We're starting our adventure in Monijiguaka, I think? After completing a few tutorial quests, we used the guide menu to teleport to Hennessy's to go whack at some golems. However, my Kana got a little bit homesick, so soon enough we found ourselves back in in Kana's hometown, training at the monsters there. Kana's geomancy skills allows you to discover mana veins. Kana can teleport to these veins directly and will recover spiritual energy faster if you're standing in one. Their main attacking skill is Shikigami Hunting, which can be pressed multiple times, similar to Demon Slayer's their basic attack. However, we're already one-shotting monsters, so I'm not really attacking multiple times yet. Thanks to all the Link skills and Legion effects my account benefits from, this character is a bit stronger than, let's say, a fresh account. For our next skill, Kana is able to summon a Ghost Yaksha, which will attack nearby enemies. And also a teleport skill, well, I kinda mentioned it already, and the skill increases int and defense, and the final first job skill is Haku the Familiar 2, that gives a speed boost and 30 luck, for some reason. Lucky us, I guess. We use the guide menu a lot to teleport to maps, like our next map Empyrean. By the way, if you find an additional fan, don't throw it away. Your summon Haku can also equip a weapon. And since Kana doesn't really have any magic guard, it might be a bit harder to survive, so it's nice to get some additional HP. Actually, Kana has a beginner skill that gives one magic attack for every 700 HP you have. So you'll be able to take more hits and get stronger at the same time. This class has it all. Pyrian got a bit too hot for us, so at level 27 we went to Illinia to train at the Evil Eye Monsters and their little brothers and sisters, until we reached level 30. Time to pop a 1-day 2x EXP card. In 8 hours from now, we will be level 200. I wanted to do something different today. You know, we always go through the same team dungeons or the same training spots, so today I went to a different team dungeon called Eladin Team Dungeon. If you want to train fast and get useful items, I recommend to absolutely not do this dungeon. Instead, go to LNL Fairy Academy or the Arena Stray Team Dungeon or just train at monsters somewhere else. This team dungeon has you like catching monsters, defeating monsters, filling up water bottles. The XP isn't that good, but the maps are really beautiful though, that's definitely a plus. For your reward, you'll only get a medal, 1 million meso and some spell traces. Thanks to our additional EXP that we're getting from the cash card, we are already level 48. So it's time to go to the Pyrian excavation site to train at the Skeledogs and Mummydogs. Even in death, they're still good boys. For every job advancement until 4 job, Kana gets an upgrade for the Shikigami Hunting and Ghost Yaksha. And in your second job, you're able to transform Haku into his human form. In his form, he grants you buffs, shields you, heals you, and increases your damage. One of his skills is dependent on the weapon attack of the fan that he has equipped, so don't forget to equip one for him. Another amazing skill that Kana gets is Exorcist Charm. This exploding charm leaves a toxic cloud that deals additional damage for 1 second. It's amazing, it's like one tick damage for 1 second. Whew. However, the cooldown is very low, and this skill is very strong for a second job skill. This does some crazy damage. You'll also get a skill that will boot you upwards and deal some damage, and Soul Bump, which makes monsters explode when you deal damage to surrounding monsters. Alright, enough training for now, it's time for some special magic mushrooms. Apparently Haku wanted some mushrooms to increase his magic. I mean, Haku just knows how to chill, man. After feeding him the mushrooms, he lets you ride him as a mount. And this mount has a crazy high jump, you can get really high while riding him. Now it's time to continue training at the Copper Sand Drakes in Sleepywood until we reach level 60 for the third job advancement. Now we can finally unlock the skill that increases spawn rate and train even faster. I had the brilliant idea to do more team dungeons this video, so I went to Mushroom Kingdom. But I don't know what happened there, but the monsters in this area give like half the EXP of monsters outside of this area, so we went out of there real quick. I paid a visit to Lucidas in Orbis before moving to Stairway to the Sky 1, as this map is just still the best map ever for this level. And with Kishin now unlocked, it gets even better, just look at this crazy amount of spawn. Kishin is a skill that can be placed down, it deals damage and increases monster spawn rate. In third job, Kana also gets another upgrade to Shikigami Hunting and Ghost Yaksha. We also get a lot of passive skills this time, like Spirit Path, which increases magical attack, critical rate, critical damage, Life Blood Ritual, which heals Kana's HP each time a monster is defeated or every few attacks on a boss monster, and the healing ratio for this skill depends on how much HP you have. I tried to look for a nice balance so that I almost never had to use any potions, making Kana really cheap to train. And there is Yoshizumi, I think that's how you pronounce it, which has a chance to deal additional damage with all these smaller projectiles flying around. Next up is Blossom Barrier, which is a barrier that can be placed for you and your party member, and you and your party members who are inside the barrier receive reduced damage and get status and knockback resistance. And finally, Tengu Strike. This skill used to be really good before Kana got revamped last year, but now when training I barely used it. Not sure if there are any Kana mains watching this who can tell me how to use it better, but for me it was a bit of a letdown compared to what it used to be. At level 83, I went to Rats in Ludibrium. This map is pretty small, so you can just teleport up and down in one spot to defeat all the monsters and all the platforms. It's actually pretty funny, because if you noticed, Kishin actually doesn't hit the monsters because they're too small. From level 84 to 93, we went to Sahel 2 in Ariant. Once we reached level 92, I could use a rune again, so it was time to go to Zakum. After unlocking the final pixel rank in a pixel event, I got some 3x EXP cards that last 30 minutes. This is the perfect time to pop one together with a rune and a 2x EXP card. This is gonna be amazing. We quickly moved to normal Zakun. Thanks to the Evan Link skill, my runes last for 4 minutes, so I have a bit of time to travel. With everything active, we defeated the 8-armed Statue of Doom. And quick fact, did you know that Zakum's look is actually inspired by real-life Mayan statues? The level animations haven't quite catched up yet, but we reached level 102. Since the card is still active, we're moving to the next map right away. I want to make the most of this card, I only have a couple of them. So we moved to Skyness 2 in Leafra, which is a map that requires a whooping 5 Star Force. Everyone should be able to get this on any like their equipment. Now we also have the Pixel Hawk active, and we still have time on our rune, so we have a crazy amount of bonus EXPs and additional damage. It takes about 14 seconds to level up. I think it took longer to do level 20 to level 21 than it took to do this level. After training a few mere minutes, we were able to reach level 113 and we moved to Dual Ghost Pirates in Ludibrium, which is another Star Force map, so if you plan on doing the same, make sure to prepare some equipment, because I actually wasted a lot of time because I had to steal Star Force and scroll some stuff while my 3x EXP card was active. Thankfully you can just place the summon and they do some damage, but still it was not the best usage for the card for me. I reached level 131, and only at this point the 30-minute 3x EXP card was almost over. So we did 39 levels in 30 minutes. Like I said, I still had to starve for some of my gear in between, and had like only 50% burning field at the birds and leafers, so we probably could have done more. By the way, if you are enjoying this video, don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe for more content. And now I was thinking like, okay, what else can I do? You know, I don't want to go to the same spots again. Ugh. You know, the thing about MapleStory is that even though there's only a couple of places that have like the best training spots, it's nice to deviate every now and then and like do something different. Maple has a lot of content that sometimes is a bit forgotten. So today we're going to the Golden Temple. This is a place I haven't visited in a long time, and it is sort of a theme dungeon. So while I'm completing that, let's go over some of the 4-job skills. We get our final Shikigami Hunting and Ghost Yaksha buffs. Haku gets a buff for his buffs, and you get a buff, everyone gets buffed, it's freaking amazing. We get a map exploding skill called Ninetales Fury. While the skill's on cooldown, there's a chance that Haku will attack enemies as well. We get to use the Shikigami Double Ganger skill, which needs to be charged using mana, and once charged, it explodes, dealing a huge amount of damage. Night Ghost Guide is a passive skill that has a chance to mark enemies. Marked enemies give more EXP and have a higher chance to drop equips. Kana gets so many good 4-job skills, it's crazy. There's Orchi Unbound, which is another attack that covers almost the entire map. It can be held down as well. And Binding Tempest, which stuns monsters, which is really useful against these reflective bosses, because you can just stun them and then you can just freely whack at them without being paranoid of dying. There's Falling Sakura, which deals damage and heals your party members. And there's another barrier called Bellflower Barrier, which increases damage and boss damage for all party members. And finally, there is the Vanquisher's Charm, which is sort of a hurricane-like skill. By the time I'm done talking about the skills, we already completed almost the entire Golden Temple. We just need to defeat the final boss Ravana to get a discount Zakum helmet and move on. I went to the training dolls in Mulong until I reached level 140. For fun, I tried out the Dimensional Invasion. This piece of content is really old, and it shows. The XP was not too bad though, and as a reward you get pieces of a glove that has okay stats. I mean, it was really good like 8 years ago. After that adventure was over, I went to defeat Horntail with a buddy, and I got 2 levels of this 3-headed behemoth. I did not have any Star Force equipment, so I couldn't train at the Star Force map in Leafra or Kerning Tower, so instead I went to the Temple of Time, then to Dark Cornians in Leafra. After reaching level 146, I went to the Sholin Temple using the guide menu. This is a team dungeon and a party area, so you can bring all your friends and complete this area together. The monster EXP in this area is actually pretty nice. And is it just me, or did the final boss for this area straight up steal Demon Slayer's attack? I mean, story-wise, this guy I'm fighting is a demon, but, you know, still. After that dungeon was done, I went to the Colossus area to train there for a couple of levels. I didn't actually do the team dungeon, and once I reached level 155, I went to Meteans in the Omega sector and stayed there until I reached level 160, and then it was time to go to the Mutant Slimes and Future Hennessys. While I whack away at the monsters here, let's go over Kana's hyper skills. The first one is Circle of Suppression. This skill creates a purple shield around you that periodically deals 500% damage to nearby enemies. Then there is a giant food summoned vertebrate Pandemonium. This skill deals a whooping 1000% damage and stuns monsters hit for 15 seconds. You can eat like a whole footlong in that time. And finally there is Princess Vow, which increases the damage of all Son Goku warrior classes by 10% for a short duration. Now, it was at this point that I realized I just need more HP. Kana can heal quite a lot if you kill monsters, but I needed to kill them fast enough and I needed to heal a bit more HP. I was still pretty squishy, to be honest. I actually died from an elite boss at this time as well. So, and I hate dying, so I invested in some Fafnir gear to increase my HP and damage. Now I will not only be able to kill faster, but I also have more HP. I think I almost doubled my HP, so now I have 40k. I also started using the Kaiserling skill, which helped a little bit as well. Even though it's only like, what, 15% of the base HP. But now, after all this upgrading, instead of healing 900 HP per kill, we're healing 2k HP. This is amazing, because now I can fight stronger monsters and I don't have to worry about using potions. Plus, you get stronger as well, because remember, Kana's beginner skill converts 700 HP to one magic attack. So, because we are doing pretty good now, we're moving to Showa to train at the Hideout. Time to pop another 3x EXP card and train like the wind. Seriously, keep an eye on that XP counter. Yeah, that's 1 minute. You can level up from levels 168 to level 169 in 1 minute. Man, I love those 3x EXP cards. We're also using a 10% EXP potion from Monster Park, and we still have the cash 2x EXP card active as well. We trained here until we reached level 177 and 90-ish%. Because the 3x EXP card was ending at this point and I wanted to level up fast, I went to Legion to spend my coins there and get these potions that give you 50% of a level until you reach level 179. You can buy 5 a week and they give a nice 2x EXP buff that lasts 30 minutes as well. So after using a couple of these potions, we're level 180 now, which means we can finally move to Future Parian. I stayed at the Swollen Stump map until I reached level 187, and after that it was time to go to Forsaken Excavation Site 2 and pop the final 3x EXP card. Now by the time this card ended, I reached level 197, but I had one more trick up my sleeve. Because we unlocked the final Pixel rank in the Pixel Anniversary event where we got those 3x EXP cards from, you can also get 10 level up potions. I already used 7 of them, so the remaining 3 potions I used on Kana to get to level 200. Easy peasy. Now that we reach level 200, we can finally unlock the 5th job advancement. We get 3 more skills, and the first skill we're going to take a look at is Liberated Spirit Circle. This skill is activated every now and then when using Shikigami Hunting and Vanquish a Charm. The skill summons a giant circle, as the name kind of suggests, that travels upwards and deals damage to every enemy in its path. It has a 25 second cooldown. The next skill is called Yuki Musume Shaokan. I'm butchering these names, I'm sorry. My farmer Dutch accent is preventing me from pronouncing things properly today. Which summons a ghost that deals damage, reduces mana consumption, and will make you recover 2% HP every attack. A great skill for both training and bossing. And finally, Spirit Domain, which summons a giant pillar that deals damage. If you are inside the pillar, your character will restore periodically HP and MP, your character gets increased final damage, and it increases status resistance. The stone at the bottom of the skill will absorb mana used by the caster, causing the skill to grow in size. It can be increased up to 3x, increasing the effect of the skill by 3x as well. When the stone is at full power, all party members within range gain 2 attack speed, and Kana no longer has to use any mana for her skill. The skill stays active for 50 seconds and has a 220 second cooldown. And that was Kana. Which class should we do next? Let me know in the comments. Many thanks to our members for making this video possible. Thanks to Quinn, Niels de Koning, Raarmawaar, Zenny, Zozil, Raferim, Krauker, The Purple Flurp and Paroxys Gaming. If you would like to be mentioned here as well and get early access to new videos, check out the join button below this video. As always, thanks for watching, stay safe, and happy mapling!